Damn. No Power Pack series in development? Shazam Fury of the Gods wrapped up his filming, though. And just possibly, I don't know, maybe we might actually get that Deathstroke series on HBO Max. Welcome to the house. Let's talk about it. What up, what up, what up? Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is Blues News. I'm your host, Bluminati, man. Why I give you that good blurred news, bring it to you daily. You know how we do it. You know how we do it. Now, slow news day, so just go over some things. Probably be real quick. Nothing real, you know what I'm saying? Nothing too hardy, nothing too major. But we're going to talk about it anyway. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Yada, yada, yada. Do the big things that you need to do to help this channel grow, man. So, first up, let's talk about Power Pack. I know a lot of y'all don't even know who Power Pack is, what it is, where they come from. It's Marvel, man. It's Marvel, you know what I'm saying? So, once upon a time, Marvel Studios was looking at several obscure character properties to try to bring to the big screen and to kickstart that financial backing for this newly founded studio. One of those happened to be Shang-Chi, and the other one happened to be Power Pack. So we spoke with Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings producer, Jonathan Schwartz, about Power Pack, a project he coincidentally attached to produce at some point in time in the past decade, and its current status. So he says, quote, "It's one of those things we look at and talk about every once in a while. We'll probably get there eventually, but it's not something super active at the moment." Now, for those of you who don't know, you know, the uninitiated, Power Pack is a superhero team made up of preteen siblings with powerful cosmic abilities who are going crazy cosmic adventures together, stuff like that. This property's been in and out of development for quite some time now throughout the years, with the most recent iteration being one that Schwartz was attached to. Now, with so many unique things in development, who really is trying to see a Power Pack, you know what I'm saying, thing with Marvel Studios right now? We got so many things in development. Power Pack feels like a property that would be served really well in animation. I co-sign that. I think you do it in animation, get it out there, let people see if they like it or not, put it on. You ain't even put it on, what it is, Disney XD. Don't put it on Disney Plus. Put it on, like, Disney XD. Because it's really a show for that. You know what I'm saying? It could be Marvel's counter to Teen Titans Go. That's how I look at it. So I think it is a bankable property, though. So I say do it like that. So that's Power Pack. Like I said, man, nothing too major. We're gonna really go through this, man. Marvel, if you're going to do Power Pack, do it with the animation thing. So next up, we have Shazam Fury of the Gods. It wrapped its filming, and it's crazy because it doesn't come out for another year and a half or something like that. So let's talk about good old Shazam and how it wrapped its filming. You know what I'm saying? So Shazam has wrapped filming. The Shazam family is returning with both the cast and the director, picking up their respective roles for another electrifying ride through the DCEU. Now, it was announced last year at DC FanDome that the next film in the franchise would be titled Shazam Fury of the Gods, leading many to wonder just what gods they would be facing since they had been killed by Ares centuries ago, right? Well, the second Shazam film is set to release 2023. Like I said, they done filming, but we won't get it till 2023. That's another year and a half, 2 years away. Director David Sandberg announced yesterday that the film was wrapped. This has left quite a large gap of time in between the end of the production and the release date, right? So, with filming having already concluded and released so far out, what could occupy that time aside from the post-production, possibly pre-production on the third film? One of the biggest issues with the film's face is with its actors. The cast is mostly made up of child actors who've all began to sprout up quite fast in these past years. Yeah, these child actors, man, I don't know what's in the water, but man, like, have you seen Stranger Things? The kids on Stranger Things? beards, goatees, and it's crazy. These kids, the way they shoot up, man, the way they shoot up. So with all the time in between, how much time we have in between releases, they could easily get cameras rolling sometime in 2022 following post-production on Fury of the Gods. And that would make sense. That'll make sense. You know what I'm saying? While we got this big gap of time, we can go ahead and start working on three or just getting some footage together. You know what I'm saying? Some pre-production footage together, stuff like that. Shazam Fury of the Gods currently set to release June 2nd, 2023 with Zachary Levi set to return as the titular character, Shazam. Or Captain Marvel is y'all. If you old school, you know that he went by Captain Marvel back in the day before Marvel sued him for the name. The film will see the family up against the daughters of Atlas, with Helen Mirren and Lucy Liu set to play two of the older sisters, Hespera and Calypso. So yeah, Shazam: Fury of the Gods finished filming. DC, maybe this will be another movie that can help DC get back on track and right some wrongs that they done. Who knows? It's DC, man. Who knows? So. Let's keep it moving. Next up, Deathstroke. Deathstroke might be getting a series, HBO Max. You know what I'm saying? Maybe we can get some Ben Affleck in there, some Batfleck. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? So, John Manganiello was casted as Deathstroke in the Justice League and is also set to appear in his own solo film in a Batman movie starring Ben Affleck. But all that fell to the wayside. But, you know, that character is Deathstroke, man. He has endured. So, Warner Brothers is in very early pre-production. Rumor has it, very early pre-production on the Deathstroke HBO Max miniseries. Warner Brothers has been financially thriving during the COVID-19 pandemic, a lot due to its HBO Max streaming service. They're investing in it as a serious contender to other streaming services like Netflix or Disney Plus. So with this early development on the series, it will touch on Deathstroke's origin in relation to the League of Shadows. But the series will also feature a contract of the week type format where Deathstroke will take on contracts to take on and fight various heroes, anti-heroes, and even other villains from the DC universe. That's kind of dope. So instead of like a freak of the week type situation, he takes on these contracts and go and fight these different characters, these different superheroes, anti-heroes, other mercenaries, other mercs. But the bad thing is they're saying Joe Manganiello may not be reprising his role as Deathstroke. It said the Warner Brothers is wanting to start fresh with the character. Fresh with the character. Hell, John Manganiello wasn't even the character, really. You can't really start fresh from something that didn't happen, you know what I'm saying? Although many sources who are associated with the project have confirmed that tonally it's being set up to match the Batman trilogy. Not to say it needs to or will have that connection, but DC wants there to be the option that the character and the actor could show up in the future sequel to the Batman. A writer is on the project with a showrunner director, and the star is still being sought after. It said that if some of these roles are filled before the upcoming DC FanDome event, the project could be announced at that time. So maybe we'll see during DC FanDome if they're going to do something as far as cast and the characters and stuff like that. But I say bring Joe Manganiello back, man. Bring him back. He was the right guy for the job. Let him do his thing. I don't see the issue with it. But like I said, that's DC doing DC things, man. I really don't get it. DC doing DC things. Y'all got to quit DCing DC when it comes to this movie thing. Y'all got to figure it out. Figure it out, man. So, yep. That has been Blues News. Like, subscribe, share, hit that notification bell. And I really ain't got nothing else for you, man. I appreciate y'all for sticking in. You can always donate at the Cash App. $BLUMINATI. And this is Blues News, where we give you that good blurred entertainment news. And you ain't got to go home, but you got to get up out of here. Peace. Be easy.